together in a bid to try and take gold come Rio, but they're outside of qualification at the moment as the third-ranked team of the USA, so they're desperately keen to get the points to show their worth and firstly get there by right and not have to rely on the association picking them as the team to go ahead of anybody else. So first glimpse of Kolesinska without the hat, Brzostek with the hat. Kerry with the white top, wearing number one, April in with the number two top.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the FIVB.
Our referee today is Wang Lei Jun from China. Camera wobbling up and down a little bit because it's up on the VIP area and they're all just wandering around. And the second referee today from South Africa is Giovanni Barker. Brzostek and Kolesinska made it to the final over Isabelle Fourré and Anouk Verge-Dupré, beating them 2-1. In the semi-final, 15-13 in 44 minutes. Now they are through to this final. So out comes Kinga Kolesinska. She's 25 from Lublin. Her best ever finish was a bronze in 2015. So they're going to go one better than that as Monika Brzostek comes out. She was a junior champion in Blackpool in 2009 at the World Championships, and now is here playing in the final of a senior event. Out comes April Ross, 33 years of age, from Newport Beach, resides in Costa Mesa, California. 16 gold medals, $892,000 in prize money, but that pales into insignificance compared to the 6 feet of sunshine. That's Kerry Walsh Jennings, 37, from Manhattan Beach, 105 tournaments, 50 gold medals, $1.3 million in prize money, and looking for more, hungry for success, and with her eyes firmly fixed on getting to the Olympics one more time to add to her already impressive Olympic haul of 3 gold medals. Away we go with the women's final. It's Poland in red serving, the USA in blue receiving. Best of 3 sets to see who'll take gold here on Copacabana Beach in Rio de Janeiro. And it's a tidy side out for the USA to open proceedings. Ross with the serve. Nice angle by Brzostek. Interesting how they're going after April. Most teams do go after April, but a lot of teams will be going after Kerry Walsh, just seeing how injured she is or not. Good swing that from April, isn't it? Good height. USA not getting a block in place, and as a result, Poland have their side out. Ross once again, USA with a slender lead. It's a wild swing. The lefty, Kolosinska, not getting the wrap she wanted. Nicely played this time by Kolosinska into the corner. Poland's road to this final has been a hard-fought one. First two matches were to three sets. They actually went to three sets against Vanuatu. Mato Atu and Miller just showing how far that Vanuatu have come along in terms of their abilities to take Poland to three sets. And they went three sets against the Slovak Republic. And they lost to Juliana and Lima, 1921, 2022. But got out of their pool, got themselves into the knockout stages, got themselves through to this final, courtesy of a 2-1 victory over Jianxu of China. Then they beat Bansley and Pavin of Canada by forfeit. So that kept them fresh for the semi-final, where they beat Ferrer and Dupree of Switzerland. And now they've got it all to do here up against the number 8 seeds from the USA of Ross and Walsh. I've managed to get themselves a point from service. And now there's an extra one. Good serve from Ross. Their road to the final has been a series of non-stop victories. It was three sets required against Paredes and Pishka of Canada in the first game, 15-8. Then they won 2-0 against compatriots Fendrick and Sweat of the United States, 17 and 17. Then they beat Russia's Belova and Ukalova in straight sets as well, before seeing Antonelli and Lily off. The Brazilians were beaten to 16 and 14. Their toughest game actually was against Laura Ludwig and Kira Volkenhorst of Germany. They lost the first set to 16, then they won 29-27 before winning 15-6. Spoke to Laura Ludwig about that. She was was a little bit disappointed, saying that they effectively felt they gave the game to the USA, but had to credit them with the fact they still went on to win it. And then they beat Carla Borga and Britta Buta 15-10 after being absolutely annihilated in their first set to 9. And in the interview afterwards with the legendary Sinjin Smith, they admitted that actually they'd never been beaten to that score together, or probably either actually playing with other partners. And Kerry Walsh said it was a twilight moment, a bit surreal as that one goes out of reach, but she just took that view. Okay, it was that moment, but they got back into it and just played the next two sets knowing it couldn't get any worse. It didn't, it got better, and now they're into this final. They've still got their 2-point lead, 8-6 up. Ross once again serving, Walsh at the net. This is their strongest rotation, because Walsh doesn't have to go in and block. That's a top serve from Ross. Sometimes it's not about the power, it's about the precision, and that was precisely down the middle, bisecting the poles, down that panic channel. Both going for it, both not talking, making the error. And a timeout called by Poland.
Keep going, keep going. Dude, so if I trust your reads.
If I drop, I'm digging myself, okay?
Yeah, okay.
I'm gonna take out the face if I need to.
Okay, yes.
Keep dropping my head, my fault.
I'll stay, you know,
to myself.
Jogos.
Another ace serve from Ross, two in a row, two straight down the middle. She's on a hat trick now. It's just that precision, isn't it? That's definitely got to have been Kozinska's pass, but she didn't move. Side out achieved by Poland. They've got a lot of work to do to get into this one now. Oh, a desperate attempt by Ross. Poland just watching and not paying attention, were they, to what was actually happening here. USA were in trouble. Well, the big throw down is thrown wide as Kerry Walsh goes with her left hand, gets the job done. Technical timeout, USA are bossing the first set of this gold medal match here in Rio. Fighting then is the order of the day for the USA. That one just squeaked past the block. Kerry Walsh Jennings, one of the nicest individuals you can meet off the court. One of the meanest, fiercest, probably most horrible you could wish to meet on the court. All in the context of sport. She's there to win, not to make friends. That's a good serve. Yeah, nice play from Walsh Jennings, jumping into that cross court and not losing sight of the fact that Kolesinska's left-handed, and she nearly got that one, didn't she? Well listened. Communication is absolutely vital when there's just the two of you. You have to listen and take the advice on board. Don't have to always act upon it. The angle or the information that's given by the non-hitter is an option. Good dig. And a good finish as well. That's well played by Brijolstek. Good play again. USA soaking up Poland's attack, coming back themselves in transition and making it count. They have a 6-point lead. This first set is all USA. Well, Ross got there, but she was a little bit tense and tight with her hands. And as a result, couldn't kind of cushion the ball and soak up that pressure or even direct it back towards where it needed to go. It was hit hard enough. She could have actually tried just to throw her hands like a volley at it, like the Brazilians do so well. Telita and Juliana, probably the two best exponents of that ability to break from there, play that high hands defense and almost catch the ball. Another testing serve for Poland. Walsh Jennings not getting in at the net, then getting herself stuck. She kind of broke and then didn't, and really was nowhere in a position to be able to play the ball. She talked about that earlier with in the timeout, saying about the breaking, and if necessary, she will take one in the face. But I'm pretty sure she doesn't want to do that. Making it, so she's talking about not dropping her head, keeping her hands up to try and play the ball. If she has to break, it doesn't get that far off. That's a good swing, isn't it, from Ross? Showing how high she gets. The net's 224. One of the hardest hitters, hardest servers on tour, April Ross. It was a good decision by the two of them to team up together. Just a shame that Walsh Jennings has had the injury she's had, which has put them in the position now of having to win just about everything, don't they, really, in this run-up to ensure a qualification for them by rights to the Olympics. That time, though, it's Poland who get the point. Again, Ross not able to continue. Could cushion the ball, trying to play it off the palms of her hands, and that means it's going to shoot straight off them. Nice play. Set point for the USA. Poland offering a little resistance. Chance to get it done. Oh, they do it the unconventional way. Walsh Jennings with the block off the head, the recovery, and then the reverse pokey. And the set goes to the USA. Right off the bounce, Dahlhauser style. Ignore that graphic. It's one set to nothing for the USA as the teams get ready to come out for set number two. And the pressure firmly on Poland now. it's fascinating to watch, isn't it? We've got this 5 minute delay between sets and the USA have gone into meditation mode. Set two is upon us, Poland with the serve. The USA receiving, they lead one set to nothing. One set away from gold here in Rio, Copacabana Beach. And a tidy side out for April Ross to give them their first point and the serve. Ostek's not had much to do in the match so far. It's all been on to Kolozinska. But when she got the chance there, she's taken it nicely. Well watched. Tracked that one all the way. Did April Ross. Knew it was going long. Swing. Kolozinska being the lefty does mean that Ross Jennings has to take a little bit more to her right than you would normally do. And that in turn then opens up the line. So it's always tricky to stop the lefties. Pokey for Poland. Just wonder whether or not they believe. Well, they're just here knowing that actually, do you know what? We got a silver. We'll be very happy with that. Let's hope it's not the case for them. They are going to try and force the issue. That's a good up. That's more like it from Poland. Gets them back into the game. Serving pressure at the moment from the USA is good enough to cause problems for Poland. And if that's all the USA need to do, that's all they're going to do. But it just shows you, it doesn't matter what the level, whether you're starting out as a beginner or whether you're playing here in a gold medal match, representing your country, serving is key. It's the one thing that you can win points from. No one has to help you. And for me, it's one of the most important elements of the game, if not the most. Because if you can't serve to score, you can't serve to put the other team under pressure, then you're never going to win. Because at the end of the day, you have to actually have scored a point from service at some point in order to win a set. Because if you just keep trading points and siding out, you just keep going on. So someone has to make that breakthrough. So from the tough serve, to put the other team under pressure, and maybe it's backed up then with a block, or the other team make an error and hit out or in the net. Serving pressure is the most important thing. Followed up with some good tactical nous, as is displayed by Kerry Walsh Jennings, just breaking off the net. Timeout called by Poland. Still doesn't seem any way in it at the moment, does it, for Poland? Physically, USA dominate. Mentally, they're dominating. And Poland are playing into their hands. They're not committing to the task. They're not committing to the shot that's in front of them. And that's just a nothing shot. It's well long, not putting anyone under pressure. Ross brings the power, and with it, another point. Well, so far, so good. It's, dare I say it, a little bit run-of-the-mill, isn't it, for the USA? Don't take it away from them. They've worked hard to get here. They're working hard now. They're making it look run-of-the-mill. They're making it look very businesslike because of the heat and the pressure from the serving. That's then putting Poland out of position. Then they're scooping it up. And Poland are having to go two, three times to get side out. Now that just adds more pressure to the team in red. They've got their side out, but they really should have got it first time. They've had to get it second time. They've had to expend all that energy. And each and every time that happens, it plays into the hands of the USA. Solid block out, good high contact, that's so important, because then in the women's game, if you're contacting that ball high against the block's not going to be able to press and get across. The only players that can get across the net and block in the women's game are Kerry Walsh Jennings, Juliana occasionally, Talita occasionally. Mistakes keep coming for Poland. Well, that one was given as in, so it's a technical timeout time. USA in control. USA fans are in and enjoying it. The fans generally are enjoying it. They've come out here to Copacabana. And we've been blessed with no rain, I guess is the best way to put it. So that's the stats so far. Spikes from Walsh 10 for NO. So 14 and 1. Those are the two players who are taking most of the ball at the moment. But Poland are pretty much mixing it up, aren't they? They're going after Ross. And it's too easy. Ross is going to put that ball down all day long. And so too, actually, is Kerry Walsh-Jennings now. She seems to have found her rhythm back into the groove here, playing in a Grand Slam. That match sharpness takes a little while to come. And that would have been reflected in those earlier scorelines in their pool matches. But it's Ross who's taking it to town for the USA. And Poland can't deal with that serve at the moment. In part because they're not moving their feet. When you start falling to the ball, you're going to be off balance. It's going to be difficult to pass it. But Ross is making it so. That's better. Pujostek. Nobody blocking, and then it becomes no bother at all for April Ross. Nicely played. You get the feeling, don't you? Poland just need either Brzostek or Kolesinska just to get angry, get mean, get nasty. But at the moment, they can't seem to manage any of that. And the USA keep piling on the pressure, piling on the misery, and piling on the points. Better. Monika Brzostek, 26-year-old from Łódź, beating April Ross with that one. Good up from Ross. Oh, good angle as well. A timid effort from Poland, punished by USA. And it's looking like the Stars and Stripes are going to be top dog here in Rio. 2 points from victory for the USA. Gold medal point then for the team in blue. Whilst Jennings with the serve scurries through to the net. And that's a tidy put away under immense pressure by Kinga Kolesinska. Saving the first match point, but can they save seven? Can they deny the USA siding out seven times in a row? That would be something, wouldn't it? Ruzostek with the serve. April Ross for gold. And she's done it. It hits the sideline. And the USA are champions here on Copacabana Beach in Rio. And they are back with a bang. They were never in trouble, were they? They had this one sussed from start through to finish. Top serving from April Ross. Good hustle and blocking from Kerry Walsh Jennings. Their attacking was sublime. Their execution was clinical. And they have exactly what they deserve. This is how it was done. Ross takes the ball. Kerry bumps it up. And then April just puts it away cross court like she does every time in training. And as she's done now for a gold medal and a big, big payday and massive points towards qualification to the Olympic Games. Confirmation of your scores, 21-15, 21-13. Statistics, errors, look at that. The USA made 2 errors compared to the 13 that Poland made, and there is the reason why Poland have a silver medal and not a gold medal. Here then are the highlights. St. John Smith's with our winners. Let's hear what they have to say.
I feel unbelievable, particularly after your surgery. So tell me something. What were your expectations coming into this event? And then winning, of course, is incredible.
Our expectations were to play very good volleyball and to handle whatever was thrown our way, and we did. Our expectations were to win every single match, no matter how ugly or beautiful it was. Our plan was to win, and it's all the execution and staying with it and staying together. And we stay together better than we ever have this tournament, and that's the start of the year, 2016. That's what we're going to do all the way through.
Awesome. Congratulations.
Thank you.